So my name is Robin Frohardt, and I'm the creator of the Plastic Bag Store. And the Plastic Bag Store is kind of hard to explain, but it's an immersive performance that takes place in a fake grocery store in which everything is made out of plastic trash. I have a very strange relationship to all these objects because, you know, I like started this project sort of being disgusted by plastic trash and pollution, but now that I like create with it, I'm always like on the hunt for special colors of bags and things, and so I kind of have a kind of aesthetic appreciation now for some of these objects. The show has so many different kind of styles of making and craft in it. There's this whole, all the plastic bag objects, obviously, but then there's shadow puppets, and there's these Bunraku style puppets. There's this whole cardboard animation that I made. It's sort of a collection of all these different art practices. And it starts in the ancient past and ends up in the far distant future.
What is this you're selling?
Knowledge water, because knowledge is virtue. Registered trademark.
It turns out people are more than willing to pay for what they had always had for free, because that slogan was so darn catchy.
What is he saying? What is the story this vase is depicting? We will never know.
Nothing exciting ever happens at this outpost. Also, the jellyfish are quite small, which is odd, being this close to the equator.
There are certain choices that we can make in our own lives regarding waste, and there's some that we have no control over. I'm trying to go deeper beyond, like, don't use a plastic bag. To me, it's just fascinating that, like, my trash connects me to someone in the future. A straw that I used in a Happy Meal as a child, like 35 years ago, is somewhere right now. But it's a closed system, so it's somewhere. For me, humor is kind of like a coping mechanism, so a lot of this is me just trying to process my feelings about all of this. But I also think that, you know, people kind of turn away from harsh images of like sea life choking on plastic bags. Like, I don't want to look at that, and that's something I care about. I can't wrap my head around these like huge numbers of like how many billions of plastic bags we're throwing away every day. Like, that's a really hard thing to grasp. And so I think by kind of being able to like laugh at ourselves, it sort of like takes the pressure off a little bit and allows us to like kind of sit with these ideas, and they can penetrate deeper, and we can have a deeper understanding, I think, instead of just having these like blanket like bad feelings, shame feelings, guilt feelings, helpless feelings. Like, we can still like think about and ponder this stuff even if we don't like know exactly what to do.